Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Learn English. My name is Mrs. Sheetal Jain Pillai and today we will be starting with a new writing skill which is lesson number 3.6 Art of Comparing. Now what do you mean by comparing? Comparing is nothing but a performance to lead a show by a compare. So in today's lesson you will be learning the art of comparing with a few important tips that will be shared. So after completing today's lesson, you will be able to compare any prize distribution ceremony or any ceremony that requires the art of comparing. So let's get started with the icebreakers. Read the given words and share with your friend what comes to your mind when you hear the word anchoring. So anchoring means presenting or coordinating for a television or a radio program. So the person who runs a game show on television is the anchor of that TV program. What do you mean by comparing? Comparing is an act as a compare for a variety of show. Now comparing means if it is a fashion show, the main host there is a compare. He is the one responsible to run the show. What do you mean by hosting programs? So host is the one who receives or entertains guests in a social or official capacity. Public speaking is also called as oration, which means giving a speech to the live audience face to face. Now, what are the essential qualities a compare must have? So the essential qualities a compare must have is good presence of mind, appropriate body language, sense of humor, confidence and knowledge. And while he has these essential qualities, he also needs to have or take precautions, like he should keep the audience constantly engaged. So there should not be any dull moment in the show. You should be confident to handle last minute changes in a formal or an informal program. You should always keep in mind that he's not the star of the program, but he is only the anchor and he needs to do his duties accordingly. You should also take precaution to follow the protocol while anchoring the official program. So there's a protocol which needs to be followed and there's a sequence. So he should adhere to the sequence and not start off something on his own. So let's understand what do you mean by the art of comparing. The person who compares a show introduces the program and participants is called as masters of ceremony or an MC or a compare announcer or a microphone controller. He is the mediator, announcer and coordinator of the events. The master of ceremony is an apt description of the anchor as he is the formal host and the facilitator of the event. There can be a wide range of events, right from highly formal ones like the seminars or conference to informal ones like annual gatherings, freshers party or weddings. The role of an MC is to warm the crowd and give them an idea of what the program is ahead. He is there to glorify the performance of all the performers with appropriate positive comments and appreciation. He should ensure enthusiasm among the viewers with active response in the form of an applause. So he should ensure that all the viewers are enjoying the performance and should ask the viewers to applaud and motivate the performers timely. He has to make sure that there is a smooth transition between different segments of the program. In fact, he has to master the skill of weaving the whole event in one artistic thread. So he needs to have that skill that the entire event should go on smoothly without any hiccups. The MC has to ensure the smooth movement of the program. Ultimately, his presence on stage should exhibit spontaneity, originality, and genuineness. The words of the speaker should choreograph his or her body language to carry his or her thoughts throughout the program with ease, grace, elegance, and confidence. Now, some of the insights of an MC is, what is the role of an MC, or if at all you all need to take up this, if you all think of an event management as a career after your 12th standard, this is a bang on lesson for you guys if you want to be an MC or a master of events. So what you need to do is practice, practice, practice in front of the mirror so that you can get rid of the stage fright that many of them still have. You need to be prepared and word perfect to innovate and add spontaneous expressions confidently on stage. You need to develop a script. This y'all will need to do now. Developing a script, you'll need to do it right now as a writing skill. You need to dress appropriately for the event. Remember that you are not the star of the show, but you introduce yourself as a mediator to the performance and the management guys. You need to breathe steadily and deeply. You need to address the audience with a smile, suitable expressions, voice modulation, and maintain eye contact. Bring pace to your delivery. Don't speak too fast. Don't speak too slow. You need to pace your speech. Control the timing of the proceedings. Don't be too late. Don't start too early. You need to control the timing because you are the main mediator. Apologize if there's any major flaw, mistake, or mishap that has happened, even though if it's not your fault. Now, prerequisites of comparing. What you already need to have in order to be a good compare is your fluency in language, clarity of thoughts, and confident. You need to have a clear mind. You need to be fluent in the language which the audience understands, and you need to be confident. You need to have a basic understanding of nature and tone of the event. Okay, so if it is a serious event, you cannot keep cracking jokes and make the audience laugh. You need to understand what is the nature, what is the type of event, and what tone you need to have. You need to have a simple but dignified style with words that come from the heart. Ability to deal or work with technicians, event organizer, and guest speakers. It is a part of your duty if you want to take this as your profession. Now, what are fillers? So while anchoring, the most crucial thing is to keep in mind to engage your audience. Fillers are those small performances to keep your audience entertained and attentive. So if you see any award show, there are few fillers in between to keep the audience entertained. This host just cannot keep hosting and just cannot keep distributing the awards. You need some kind of entertainment. So in the dance shows or in your award functions, you have these stars performing in between. So that is a matter of entertainment for your performance, which is an example of fillers. The role of a filler can also be that of providing comic relief between two performances. So it's like a break between two big performances. They are usually required when the schedule of the program is delayed or disturbed for some reason. So if anything is running late, you can put in your fillers as a dance performance so that the show must go on. Nothing should be stopped in between just because of anyone's mistake. So one can choose from multiple types of fillers, such as a mimicry item, which means a joke, like what Kapil Sharma does, a mimicry item. You can ask riddles. You can engage with your audience. Speak about your anecdotes, your personal experience. Talk about fun facts, jokes, recitation, or a small performance to suit the event. The compere should keep the fillers ready beforehand in the same way that he or she keeps the script ready. So if at all something happens and you need to stop in between, you need to have these fillers ready beforehand, just exactly as you have your script ready. One must keep in mind that fillers are important as they bind the program and maintain its continuity. Let's see how to write a comparing script, which will be included for your written exam. If not this year, definitely next year. Okay, so you need to start with an introduction. So if you are the compere, you will start by saying, "Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I extend a very warm and heartfelt welcome to you on behalf of our college. Today, we have organized an evening of song, dance, and pageantry for you, giving you a quick, exotic taste of India. We welcome you all in our midst in the traditional Indian way, with Kumkum Tilak on the forehead. It is red to signify the auspicious occasion of Aarti, to remove the evil eye with sacred fire, and trumpet signaling the beginning of the function. I call upon Mrs. XYZ to light the lamp to signify the opening of our event. Our country, India, is historically ancient, spiritually deep, geographically vast, and culturally rich. She has traditions, customs, and more, which are thousands of years old. Though making fast progress in the 21st century, her music, dance, drama, and languages survive and renew themselves continuously through the ages. We offer you this evening a tantalizing glimpse of Indian culture. We shall try to take you to the various corners of India and introduce you to different folk dances hailing from these places, unerringly depicting the geography, history, and character of its people. The enduring legend of Lord Krishna and his beloved Radha is embodied in the folk dance we are about to present to you, the Lavani. The word Lavani comes from the word Lavanya, which means unearthly beauty. It is the best love and very popular folk performance originating in our very own state of Maharashtra. It consists of a range of romantic songs in Marathi. The Lavani, like all folk forms, have evolved and changed through the ages. Initially, the Lavani was performed in a baithak or sitting position accompanied by adakari or skillful and subtle facial expressions, gestures. The Lavani then evolved to become the Khadi Lavani, or the Lavani performed in a standing position whereby the performer not only sings but dances along with the song. The song are supposedly sung by gopis or milkmaids who epitomize bhakti or devotion to Lord Krishna or the Lord of Love. The songs are a celebration of love between Lord Krishna and Radha and depict the playful aspects of their relationship. The Lavani embodies the Shringar Rasa. Shringar means decorating and dressing up the rasa in the mood that is created. Let's go into the mood and enjoy the scintillating Lavani performance. So you will wait for 1 or 2 seconds if you're the compere. You let the performance get over. And then once it's over, now put your hands together for a round of applause for this wonderful performance. Coming up next is Nagaland. Nagaland is one of the culturally rich northeastern states of India. The Jhelian Bamboo Naga dance hails from the state. Stop, let them perform, and then say, "That was an awesome performance." Jhelian means butterfly. The dance attempts to imitate the movements of a butterfly, and the dancers wear clothes as colorful as butterflies' wings. Their movements too are delicate and graceful as butterflies. The dancers wear costumes made of rabbit skin, deer, and other animals. The special attraction of this dance is that the dancers jump on bamboos, and now they dance with great energy and stamina. Give them a huge round of applause. Coming up next is a vibrant Northeastern dancers for another captivating performance. Sambalpuri is a small district of the state of Orissa, which lies to the northeastern part of India. It is rich in ancient Indian arts and craft. This tiny district is famous for its handlooms and weaves. The Sambalpuri dance is, like many other folk dances, a harvest dance, a celebration dance. The hay surrounding the area where the dance is to be performed is set on fire, and in the firelight, the native folk dance celebrate a good harvest. Let's get into the celebratory mode to enjoy a bountiful harvest. Now we are addressing the closing. So ladies and gentlemen, we were transported into the world of flow, the natural spring of the human heart. As we come to the end of this beautiful, colorful evening, let us carry with us the memories of a time well spent. No program would be a success without a dedicated team of people who work tirelessly behind the scenes. I take this opportunity to thank each and every member of the organizing team for putting up this brilliant show and transporting us to the plentiful fields of India. We are extremely grateful to our guests for their gracious presence. I would like you to take this opportunity to thank the choreographers, set designers, light operators, as well as technical support team, without whom this program would have not been possible. Last but not the least, thank you audience for being so supportive and responsive. So this is the way we will have to script an entire art of comparing script for our writing skill. So you will have the introduction, the welcome speech. Then you will have the lighting of the lamp. If you have a welcome song, you will introduce that. What are the main events? What are the events that you all will be talking about, if it is a dance or a drama? And then you will talk about the vote of thanks. So all this will be given to you. So you will have to prepare an introduction speech. You will have to prepare a welcome speech. You will have to invite somebody to light the lamp. Then you will call upon students for the welcome song. Tell the audience what the welcome song is, what does it depict, from where is it got, why did you all chose this song. Talk about your main events, like the example given right here. Then you will talk about your vote of thanks. Thank the chief guest, thank the audience, thank the dedicated team who put their heart into the program. So we have just one question for brainstorming. So what are the, imagine that you wish to organize a cultural event in your college. Prepare your own web chart to indicate the qualities that you expect to have in a compere. Obviously, a compere should have good communication skills, knowledge of the subject, proper attire, good presentation, good presence of mind. He should speak. He should think before speaking. His thought should be absolutely clear, not running in two or three places. He should be of cooperative nature and adjust with the school or college authorities. He should have variation in voice, which means if he has to introduce a joke, he needs to be in a high pitch. If he has to talk about something serious, he needs to be in a moderate pitch. He needs to be enthusiastic throughout the event. And he should have a great sense of humor. So imagine that you are a compere of a prize distribution ceremony of your college. Write a script of the same. Now you can take help of these following points, and you can take the help of the sample which is given in your textbook. Taking the help of your sample, you can prepare a script on a prize distribution ceremony, which will cover all these 6 points. Start with your introduction, a brief introduction of your program. Then you will welcome all your guests, thank your audience. If you have this felicitation ceremony, you will call your guests and the principal to come up on stage. Then followed by a lightening of lamp, lightening the lamb, which you will call your chief guest and the principal ahead and request them to ride the lamb. Then you will have a welcome song. So what is this song? Who is going to perform it? You will mention in detail. Then you will talk about your main events. What are the main events in your prize distribution ceremony? And later on you will talk about your vote of thanks. You will thank the audience, you will thank your chief guest, you will thank the participants, you will thank the office management, you will thank the entire college for being supportive. So that's all. We have completed all the lessons in writing skill, right from lesson number 3.1 to lesson number 3.6. Please go through this video. We will discuss all the doubts in our upcoming session. Thank you very much, students. Please do your assignments. Until next time, see you. Take care. Bye-bye.